Welcome to the statics tutorials. So if for this problem, we have a block that's resting on a rough surface and we have friction. We have a coefficient of static friction of 0.250 and a coefficient of kinetic friction of 0.225. The problem's asking us, what is the smallest force F here to cause impending motion? And it's not telling us what kind of impending motion, so this block could either slide or it could tip over. So we'll need to investigate both cases. Here's our free body diagram. We have our force F. We have the weight of the block. Make sure that you convert the 125 kilograms over to newtons by multiplying by 9.81. We have the normal force, and then we have the frictional force. We can do some of forces in the y direction. And we've got the weight and the normal force S, and that allows us to calculate the normal force. And then for impending sliding, we can go ahead and do sum of forces in the X, but in place of the frictional force, now that we're at impending sliding, the frictional force will equal the static coefficient of friction times the normal force. We're not yet in the kinetic regime. We're just looking at this up to impending motion, not past that, not into motion. And that's why we're using the static coefficient of friction. Plugging that in, we can now solve for F and we get 311 newtons. We also need to investigate the force required to tip this block over. Or we need to investigate and make sure that the normal force is still on the block. Usually it's faster just to go ahead and calculate the force to tip the block over, because then if you find that the normal force is not on the block, you've already got the other force calculated and you don't need to do a separate calculation. So looking at impending tipping, as it starts to tip over, the normal force is going to shift over to point A, and then once the normal force is at point A, you're going to have impending tipping. So we can do a sum of moments about point A. We'll have the positive moment from the weight, the 127 kilograms times 9.81 times a half of the width of the block, so half the 0.3. That'll be a positive moment. And then we'll have a negative moment about A caused by the force F, and we'll multiply that by the overall height of the block. So solving for this, we get that F is equal to 312 newtons. The force over here is slightly lower, and so this indicates that we're going to get up to impending sliding. And then if we put 311 newtons, if we put a hair over that, it would go into sliding in the kinetic regime. It's never going to hit impending tipping. So when you investigate these multiple cases, make sure that you find the one that has the lowest force and then report that as the case that will happen. So if this was on an exam, we would mark this number. We would say F is equal to 311 newtons, and we'd make sure that we said impending sliding will occur so that we make sure that we convey that we've identified which of the two cases. Thanks for watching.